Do not be afraid of the command line. You're about to become a wizard, or at least start learning how to become one. You're a wizard, Harry. Sorry, I'm a huge Harry Potter nerd. I've got a Gringotts gold brick on my desk. In this episode, you're gonna start using the command line to do some stuff in Windows. Not crazy stuff, we're just gonna meander around the file system. What I showed you in the previous episode, we're gonna do the same thing via command line. Let's get started. So, of course, you're gonna follow along with me because you need hands-on. You're gonna launch your Windows operating system. If you already have one up, you're good. Now, we're gonna go to our search bar. Now, back in the day, we would launch command prompt. We type in CMD, launch this guy. And this is like the modern, oh, I forgot. I disabled it in a YouTube video. Can't even use it. That's good though, because we don't need to use it. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go watch that video. The better option now, installed on Windows 11 by default, you can install it in the Windows Store on Windows 10. It's called Terminal. It's amazing. So go ahead and launch that right now. Here by default, your terminal will launch into a PowerShell shell. We're not gonna go too deep into PowerShell right now, but just know that PowerShell is powerful. And as you're learning Windows, this is a thing you're gonna really wanna start to learn slowly as you learn Windows. It's basically their own little programming scripting language that you can do so much with. For now, we're just gonna kind of play with it a bit. First thing I want you to notice is where we're at. So here, it tells us. Right here next to our blinking cursor, it says, hey, right now you're in the C directory. That's our drive, right? That's what we learned in the last episode. We're in the users directory, and right now we're in our user directory. We're in Network Chuck. How cool. Or whatever yours is. It'll most often, most likely default to this when you open it. Now, a fun command you can try right now is type in, who am I? No spaces, just like this, hit enter, it'll tell you. You're Network Chuck. No, I am. Sorry, I don't know what I was trying to do there. Now I wanna try and see what is actually here. Like, I'm in the Network Chuck directory, I know that, but what's in here? I wanna see it. To do that, all we have to do is type in dir. D-I-R, it's short for directory, and it's gonna list the contents of our directory. Ready, set, go. And look at that, there's all my stuff right there. Now, because PowerShell is awesome, you can also type in ls, and it will do the same thing. Ls is from Linux, and also Mac. So that command, ls, will work everywhere. I prefer that, but D-I-R is good too, because if you're in a command prompt, you don't have access to Terminal or PowerShell, it'll work there. Now we can use that same dir command to look inside of other directories. Like right now, what if I wanna look inside the downloads directory? I can just type in dir and type in downloads. And it will look inside there specifically and pull it up for me. But what if I wanna go back in time? Not deeper into the directory, but what if I wanna look inside the users directory or even just the C directory? We can do that too. If I type in dir, I'll start with C. That's the root. That's the beginning of our drive. We'll do a colon. If I just do that, let's check it out. Oh wait, no. We need our backslash to say, look at the very beginning. There we go. It's showing us the root. So how do we see the hidden stuff? This command is weird and I like it. I love it so much. Get dash child item. Get that child item, which essentially is just listing our files, just like dir or ls. Now to bring up your last command real quick, you can hit your up arrow on your keyboard. There he is. So we'll say get child item. We'll specify our C drive once more with C colon backslash. So if we hit, actually, if we do that real quick, it'll show us our C drive just like before. But if we hit our up arrow once more and we do a dash force, we're gonna force it to make us see everything. Look at that. That's pretty cool. Now to clear your terminal, if it might be getting messy for you, just type in clear. Or you can do Control C. I'm sorry, Control L. Control L will clear. I don't know what I was thinking. Control C is copy, Chuck. And I'm gonna show you two more things before we make this video too long. If you wanna jump around in your terminal to different spots in your operating system, you can use the CD command. CD, which stands for change directory. This command works in pretty much every OS, Linux and Mac. So if I CD, I know I have a directory in my user directory called desktop. I'll CD into desktop. Whoa, do you see that? It just changed my location. I'm now in the desktop directory. If I type in ls, there's nothing on my desktop. Let's change that. Let's go to the desktop and create a little text file. Now let's try it, ls. There it is. Now what do I do if I wanna go back? This command, same as before, type in cd, but then right after that, we'll hit a space and then a dot dot saying, hey, take me back, dot dot. I don't know. that's how I feel about it. And it takes us back and we can keep going. Cd dot dot, ooh, now we're back in users. Cd dot dot, now we're back at the root. Cd dot dot. Can't go back anymore. You're as far back as you can go. Now let's kind of go back in. Let's have fun with it. Let's go CD users, CD network chuck, CD desktop. If you want to go all the way back real quick with one command, CD backslash, we're all the way back. Isn't that fun? Just kind of jumping around. You can also specify an entire path and go there. So if I want CD users, network chuck, desktop, it takes me straight there. I don't have to get, you know, jump, hop each step. I can just take one big leap. Let's clear it up. Control L. I'm gonna cd back into my home directory, cd dot dot. One more fun command, it's called tree. I love trees. If you type in tree, it'll give you a really fun view of your current directory and the structure. Look at that. How nice is that? If we go back one more, like cd dot dot to where we're in the users directory, it'll look more fun. Type in tree. That's cool. If we go all the way to C, type in tree. Ah, too much. Hit Control C to stop that nonsense. By the way, if you're running anything and it's like just running and you want it to stop because you can't do anything, hit Control C. That'll stop it. So as you're like working in Windows and you're in a command line, this is a very helpful view for you. And you can use the tree command in a similar way as CD. If you want to tree just a certain directory or a certain folder, we can do tree users network chuck. So this may have been your first intro into kind of playing with the command line, and you learned a few tools, a few tricks. There will be more, don't worry. So if this was fun for you, oh, it's about to get crazy. So let's keep going. I'll see you in the next episode.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. For more IT courses just like this one, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.